brought your coat, Arthur.
You remember you told me off when Pauline was doing too much. You said she was the pop of the family and we should help. She was proper poorly. Do you remember?
Yes, I remember.
Respect is every London's dream to get out of it, isn't it? To get out in the country. Well, that's my little bit of country out there. You know, you can walk miles in the country without seeing anything, do you know that?
Yeah.
September. When I was in it, but that's when we went. September was the month. Sometimes. We'd stay over for apple picking, some years.
September, yeah.
Hot picking. The old family used to go. A blooming great bonfire, and everybody laughing and singing. And me and my mate Billy, we used to go fishing. We were going to live in the country, my dad said. No, it was all talk. Just talk. Emigrate to Australia. Didn't know. You shouldn't build people's hopes up and then not do anything. And when he had a drink, he was a bastard. Do you know? Here. My old mum, here.
I think I should look at your hand, Arthur.
I see this poor woman with her hands like this. Frustrated, all her dreams gone. She was beautiful. Had beautiful hair and beautiful eyes. She had nothing except an old man that hit her when he was drunk. And she held this up. This statue. A bloody old chalk statue. It wasn't worth a rubber. And he broke it. And she said, "You broke it." So it was something special. And it was to her. I wondered why. I said, "Why?" And she said, "It's not the statue, it's not the statue." And I didn't understand. Anyway, where was I? We got no friends, none. Pete and Coffee, they're not friends. See his sister struggling like that. Like you say, Pauline's very poorly. You got to help. I tried, but they wouldn't take Mum. Not for just one day. Not for just one day. The bastards! Oh, help me! For God's sake, help me!